What's up, Red Dirt Outdoorsman here. I'm doing a quick little review slash improvement that I've made to this stack on. It's a gun safe, but I call it more of a gun locker because it doesn't really add the fire protection that most gun safes do. It's, just this metal, but it, really is designed to keep your gun safe, keep the kids out of them. And it was pretty cheap. I saw them everywhere between $150 to $200. Tractor Supply had this one on sale for $100, so picked it up because I needed some more room in my gun cabinet. I really couldn't buy any more guns until I did something for some storage. So one reason I like it is it has a key. I prefer keys and old school combinations as opposed to the push buttons, but that's a personal preference. And inside, you've got a shelf right here. So I've got a magazine there that's loaded as a backup mag. And then I've got a few guns in here that y'all have seen before. Keep the AR there. It's not chambered, but the magazine is loaded. So if I hear a bump at the night, I bump the charging handle back, chamber the round, and I can address a threat with a 30-round magazine. And then I can toss my wife my 1911, and she can defend herself and the kids while I go figure out what's going on. And it has the flashlight and all that. And it's there at the front so that it's the first one I can grab. Right here is the extensions because it does have optics on it. It does have to have that so that it can actually be in there without, because there's no room in between here. I can barely get my fingers between the gun and the safe. But if you'll notice, the barrel of that 10/22, this is the top of the place where the gun rests on. And it just barely clears, it doesn't even actually clear all the way above that rest there. And when I first put them in, it didn't even come all the way up. My daughter's 10/22 wouldn't make it all the way up, so I had to do something to the floor. This is the foam that comes with it. I didn't want to put things in here that would prop them up, but what I did do was I cut 2x4s and I lined the floor of the safe with the 2x4s. That way, all of the firearms that go in here are now tall enough. My AR wouldn't reach, even with the six position all the way up. Now I can get it in there correctly to where it's not below the gun rest. And my shotgun is the longest gun I have, and it still has 3 to 4 inches before it touches the ceiling. So this is a 14-gun cabinet. Pretty satisfied. It's a simple key locked locker style safe by stack-on. And with that 2x4 floor addition that I was able to put the factory little foam mat on top of, it works perfect for the carbines that I have, for the smaller firearms that I own, and even fits the full-size deer rifles, shotguns that I have without any problem. Now, with this style of safe, they are pretty light. Well, I carried this in here by myself. It's pretty light, but the intention is that you anchor it into your wall and even your floor if you can. Which is what I've done with some drywall screws and bolts, and it's in there now. So before I could rock it back and forth, now it's a solid addition to the inside of my closet, where if there's a bump in the night, I can get to a gun, address the threat, and still keep my kids out. Thanks again for watching. You can leave a comment down if you have a question, or if you've got other things. I'm thinking about adding a light inside there so it's easier for me to see what's going on. I might add some things on the side, up here on the top. Still other things I can do, just haven't done them yet. But comments, leave them below. Like the video if the floor thing helps you out at all, or if you were thinking about a 14-gun cabinet but wanted to see one first before you bought. And, you know, definitely subscribe to the channel. That way I can continue to progress and make things better. Thanks again for watching Raider Outdoorsman, and we will catch you next time.